problems. Today we'll see how mathematics can be used in day-to-day activities. Come, let's meet Vimal, a brilliant student of 8th standard. Vimal's family consists of an old ailing grandmother, his parents, and a younger sister. 3 months ago, Vimal's father met with an accident. As a result, he can't work now. And Vimal had to quit school and started working for home. He was suggested by his uncle to run a vegetable cart by borrowing some money from the bank. Vimal gets up early every morning and goes to the wholesale market to buy vegetables. Today Vimal bought potatoes, onions, ginger, garlic, spinach, cauliflower, pumpkin, radish, and green chilies. You can see their price according to the wholesale market. After returning home, Vimal prepared a list like this. Kids, can you tell the difference between the two lists? You can pause the video to find out the difference. For example, look at the prices of potato and onion. Yes, Vimal has increased the prices of all the vegetables by 2 rupees. This extra money is Vimal's daily earnings. Oh, let's see. Sharma auntie is buying some vegetables from him. She bought 2 kgs of potatoes, 1 kg of onions, 1/2 kg of radish, 1/2 kg cauliflower, and 1/2 kg of ginger. Let's together find out the total price of Sharma auntie's purchase from Vimal. You can pause the video and calculate it with the help of Vimal's list. According to Vimal's list, 1 kg of potato cost rupees 20. So, 2 kgs will cost 2 multiply by 20 means 40. 1 kg onion is 12 rupees. 1 kg radish is 10. So, it is half of it. On adding 5 up to 2 times gives us 10. So, cost of 1/2 kg radish is 5 rupees. Similarly, if 1 kg cauliflower costs 6 rupees, half of it will cost 3 rupees. Now we are left with 1/2 kg ginger, means half the price of 1 kg. You can pause the video and calculate it. 1 kg ginger costs 30 rupees, means 1/2 kg ginger will cost half of 30 rupees. On dividing 30 into 2 equal halves, we will get 15. So, 1/2 kg ginger will cost 15 rupees. So, this is the cost of shopping done by Sharma auntie. Now, let's add all this to find out the total price. Kids, you can pause the video to find out the sum. Look, Vimal has already added all the numbers. Is your total is also 75 rupees? Sharma auntie has to give 75 rupees to Vimal. A few notes have been placed in front of you. Let's help Sharma auntie to add the total price. You can use each note only once. You can pause the video to choose the note on your own. Have you guessed the same? Well done! Look, Vimal is giving some green chilies to his aunt for free. You saw Sharma auntie gave 75 rupees to Vimal. Can you guess how much profit Vimal has gained? Let's calculate this together. This is the price of the wholesale market. According to this, Sharma auntie should give rupees 36 for 2 kg potatoes, rupees 10 for 1 kg onion, rupees 4 for 1/2 kg radish, rupees 2 for 1/2 kg cauliflower, and rupees 14 for 1/2 kg ginger. So, the total is 66 rupees. According to this, the costing of Sharma Aunty's shopping should be Rs. 66. But according to the pricing set by Vimal, Sharma Aunty had to give 75 rupees. On subtracting 66 from 75 gives 9. So kids, Vimal has gained 9 rupees on the purchase made by Sharma Aunty. So today we all have learned how to use mathematics in daily life activities. Real life problems. Today we'll see how mathematics can be used in day-to-day activities. Hey kids, you already know this talented boy Vimal, right? And this is his family. As you know, Vimal runs a vegetable cart to earn for his family. He was suggested by his uncle to take a loan from the bank for his vegetable cart. Vimal had borrowed 500 rupees from the bank to set up the vegetable cart. As a result, he pays 51 rupees to the bank every month. Vimal told his father that within 10 months, he will repay all the money to the bank. Kids, can you tell how much total money Vimal has to pay back to the bank? You can calculate this by pausing the video. We can calculate it like this. 51 multiplied by 10 gives 510. Vimal will pay 510 rupees to the bank in 10 months. Before taking money from the bank, one of the neighbors, Ghanshyam, suggested Vimal's father to borrow money from Pushkar, the moneylender. He said if Vimal borrows 500 from Pushkar, then at the end of 10 months, he had to return only 550 rupees to him. Kids, now you tell, which was the best suggestion for borrowing money? Bank or moneylender? You can pause the video to find out the answer. After 10 months, Vimal will repay 510 rupees to the bank, while 550 rupees to the moneylender. So, Vimal has to repay less money to the bank. Have you guessed the same? Vimal is good at maths. That's why he has borrowed money from the bank itself. As you already know, Vimal loves to study. He daily encourages his sister to go to the school, and he himself is studying in the night school. He also wants to go to the college and then someday wants to start a shop of his own or maybe work in an office. So kids, today we all have learned how to use mathematics in daily life activities. Real life problems. Today we'll see how mathematics can be used in day-to-day activities. This is Kareem Bhai. Last year, the yield of his crops was not so good. He watched in the Krishi Darshan program on Panchayat Kharch TV that the fertile capacity of land reduces due to years of farming. He also learned that if he grows grains of pulses along with wheat, the soil of his field will become fertile again. Today Kareem Bhai is very happy and is going to buy some seeds of wheat and pulses. He bought 250 kgs of seeds of wheat and 5 kg seeds of pulses. If the cost of 50 kilograms of wheat seeds is 1100 rupees, and the cost of 1 kilogram of pulses seeds is 120 rupees. So how much money did Kareem Bhai spent on pulses seeds? Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. The cost of 1 kg of pulses seeds is 120 rupees. So, the cost of 5 kgs would be 120 multiplied by 5, 600. Kareem spent 600 rupees on pulses seeds. So, Kareem bhai has bought the seeds and now is thinking how to sow them. Let's help him. This is the size of Kareem bhai's field. He is thinking to plant both the seeds in this way. At this point, his friend Vijay arrives and suggests him that changing the sides of the crop on regular basis helps to maintain the fertility of the soil. Kareem liked the suggestion of his friend and sowed the seeds in the similar way. After 3 months, see how the pulses crop of Kareem is booming. Although it's still time for the wheat crop to get ready for the harvest, Kareem called workers to help him to harvest the pulses. Together they harvested 1 acre of crops in a day. So, can you tell how much time will they take to harvest 5 acres of crops? Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. Yes, 5 acres of pulses will take 5 days to be harvested. Look, Kareem is going to the market to sell his pulses. Shopkeeper gives him 1,40,000 rupees. Kareem is very happy. Kids, if the selling price of 1 kg of pulses is 70 rupees, then how many kgs of pulses did Kareem sell? Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. Should we subtract or divide 70 by 1,40,000? Yes, you are right. We will divide. Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. On dividing 1,40,000 by 70, we get 2,000. So, Kareem had sold 2,000 kilograms of pulses in these 3 months. Now, let's see how much profit Kareem has gained. Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. He bought pulses seeds of 600 rupees. He gave 15,000 rupees to the workers. On adding both the amounts, we will get 15,000 and 600 rupees. Kareem got 1,40,000 rupees on selling the crop. If we subtract 15,600 from 1,40,000, we will be left with 1,24,400 rupees. So kids, Kareem has clearly made a profit of 1,24,400 rupees. Look how happy is Kareem. Today we learned how to use various operations in mathematics. Today we'll see how mathematics can be used in day-to-day activities. Hey kids, you already know about Kareem brother, right? 6 months before, he had sown the seeds of pulses and wheat in his field. 3 months before, he had harvested the pulses. Now look, his field is booming with the wheat crops. In order to protect his crop field from unseasonal rains and insects, he wanted to harvest and sell it as soon as possible. For this, he hires 15 laborers. Together, they harvested 1 acre of crops today. So kids, can you tell how much time will they take to harvest 5 acres of crops? tickets, you can pause the video and calculate it. If it takes 1 day to harvest 1 acre of crops, so 5 acres of crops will get harvested in 5 days. See, together they harvested the whole field in 5 days. Today Kareem is going to the market to sell his crop again. His crop is being weighed in the shop. The shopkeeper gave him 1,53,000 rupees. Kareem is very happy. If the selling price of 1 kg wheat is 17 rupees, so can you tell how many kgs of wheat is sold by Kareem? Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. If we can buy 1 kg of wheat at the rate of 17 rupees, how much wheat can be purchased with 1,53,000 rupees? For this, we'll use the operation of division. On dividing 1,53,000 by 17, we'll get 9,000. So Kareem has sold 9,000 kilograms of wheat today. Kareem has reached his home and is doing the calculations. He wants to see how much profit he has made today. As you know, Kareem had bought 250 kilograms of wheat seeds. 50 kilograms of wheat seeds cost 1100 rupees. So the price of 250 kilograms of wheat seeds will be 50 multiplied by 5, which is 250. So 1100 multiplied by 5 is, kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. We can also add 1100 up to 5 times, like this. Or we can multiply 1100 by 5 like this. So kids, have you noticed, we have got the same answer with both the operation of mathematics, 5000 and 500. You can choose any of the operation whichever you find easier. So Kareem had spent 5500 rupees on wheat seeds. Kareem pays 500 rupees to each worker for a day's work. So in total, how much money did Kareem pay them for 5 days of work? Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. A worker got 500 rupees as wages for a day. So total wages for 5 days is 500 multiplied by 5 means 2500 rupees. There were a total of 15 workers, so we'll multiply 15 by 2500. And the answer is 37,500 rupees. In total, Kareem gave 37,500 rupees to the workers. Come, let's find out the total profit earned by Kareem. Kids, you can pause the video and calculate it. 5,500 rupees was spent on wheat seeds. Total wages paid to laborers was 37,500 rupees. On adding both of them, we'll get a total of 43,000. Kareem got 1,53,000 on selling the wheat crops. Now if we subtract 43,000 from 1,53,000 rupees, we'll get 1,10,000. Oh wow, Kareem has earned a profit of 1,10,000 rupees. Kareem is very happy because by growing two different kinds of crop, his field has become more fertile. At the same time, now he can buy a cow with the profit he earned by selling both the crops. He is also planning to keep the rest of the money in the bank. So today we learned how to use various operations in mathematics.